Hello, this is Dr. Pooja Dalal. Today I will be talking about the sense organ, the eye. Eye enables us to see the object. So I have drawn a diagram of cross section of eye. Eye has got three layers. The outer layer is sclerotic layer, also known as sclera. The middle layer is choroid and the innermost layer is retina. So there are three concentric layers of the eye. What are the three layers? Sclera, choroid, retina. Now we'll talk about the sclera. So sclera is the outermost layer. It is protective, fibrous tissue, and it is white. So when it comes in front, it bulges in the white part. So sclera in front becomes cornea, which is visible through a transparent layer, which is conjunctiva. Now this cornea, you must be knowing that more than 4 to 5 lakh people in India are becoming cornea blind every year. So this is the layer of the eye which can be grafted. So Ames Institute can make corneal layer into 2 to 3 layers and we can give vision. Like suppose I donate my eyes, I can give vision to 2 to 3 people. So corneal is the only layer which can be grafted. The middle layer is choroid. It is richly supplied with the blood capillaries. So it has blood vessels. This is the important layer and this is the most commonly asked question in the boards. Which name the layer which is richly supplied with the blood vessel? So that is choroid. Iris is an extension of this choroid. What is iris now? The bigger part, the bigger round black part of your eye is the iris. So basically iris gives color to your eye. So blue color, black color, green color. There are many different types of color of the eye which is given by the iris. Again, most important question asked, what is the extension of choroid? Iris. Name the layer which gives color to the eye or which imparts color to the eye. Again, iris. Inside the iris, you must have seen a small round circular area that is known as pupil. So iris has got two layers, which is radial or the circular layers. So this layer basically leaves a small opening which is known as pupil. So pupil basically it edges the opening and closing, that is the constriction and widening of the pupil, controls the amount of light entering inside the eye. Another important question, name the part of the eye which regulates the amount of light entering inside the eye. So next layer is the innermost layer, which is the retina. Retina is the innermost layer which is richly supplied with the sensory cells known as rods and cones. Now these rods, they are most sensitive to the dim light. It has got a visual purple. It has got a pigment which is visual purple. And what is the technical name? Rhodopsin. Very important question again. Name the pigment present in the rods. Rhodopsin. Another part is cones. Cones are sensitive to the bright light and they give color perception. And cones have another pigment which is iodopsin. Is it clear? So the innermost layer is retina, richly supplied with the sensory cells. What are the two cells? Rods and cones. What are the two pigments? Rhodopsin and iodopsin. This is clear till here? Okay, now we'll talk about the most important thing, the lens. Lens is crystalline biconvex. It helps in refraction of the light and forms the image on the retina part. So lens is held by the suspensory ligament. So these are the suspensory ligament which are finely attached with the ciliary muscles. So suspensory ligament and the ciliary muscle holds the lens in its position. So that is the most important part. And finally, the eye has got two chambers, the aqueous chamber here in the front and the vitreous chamber behind the lens. The aqueous chamber is present between the cornea. See, you can see in the diagram, between the cornea and the lens. And this has got a fluid which is known as aqueous humor. Now, what is the function of this aqueous humor? It basically lubricates, moistens our eye. You must have seen while driving your eye become very dry. So basically you are lacking with the aqueous humor. So you should have lots of water. So this basically keeps our eye moistened. This aqueous humor, very important. Again, This question is also important. And this vitreous chamber, which is present behind the lens and the retina, between the lens and the retina, this has got another jelly-like substance, which is known as vitreous humor. And vitreous humor maintains the shape of the eyeball. So these are the two chambers, the aqueous chamber and the vitreous chamber. Now next is the two spots. So our eye has two different types of spots. One is the yellow spot and second is the blind spot. Now retina, I told you earlier, retina is richly supplied with the sensory cells, rods and cones. Now these rods and cones, they are mostly concentrated at one part, that is yellow spot. Another important question, area of best vision, yellow spot. Another name of yellow spot, macular lutea or fovea centralis. Sometimes they've given in the board exam, I've seen only fovea they give or only macula they give. So it becomes difficult to relate. So you learn all the three names, yellow spot, fovea centralis and macular lutea, area of best vision. Why? Because the rods and cones are maximum concentrated at this part. Another part, blind spot. Blind spot is the area of no vision because the sensory cells, rods and cones are negligible here. There are no cells. So this is the area of blind spot. That is the area of no vision. Again, very important question. Area of best vision, yellow spot, macular lutea or fovea centralis. Area of no vision, blind spot. Now let us see how eye enables us to see the object. So there are various different parts. See, I will draw with the arrow how the light enters. So sabse pehla, the eye will enter through this cornea. This arrow I am showing. So it enters through this cornea part. Inside, this cornea will refract the light towards the lens. Lens refracts. So this is the focusing of the light, which gets focused on the retina part, that is the yellow spot. So image is formed on the retina, which is basically real and inverted. So image formed is real and inverted. Now this sensory cell, they cause certain chemical changes, and this optic nerve takes this chemical signal to the brain, and this brain interprets and we are able to see the object upright. So this is how we can see the object. I will wind up my lecture here. See you in the next video, again with the continuation of eye.